Welcome back to the physics class. Now, as we have seen that how a nuclear fission reaction takes place. In the process of nuclear fission, enormous amount of energy is released. So, how to utilize this energy or how to control this energy which is coming out from a nuclear fission reaction? See, we have seen in the chain reaction that the reaction will not stop unless and until we control these neutrons which are coming out. Unless and until we control these neutrons to go and disintegrate an uranium atom. So the place or the device in which this nuclear fission reaction takes place in a controlled manner is known as nuclear reactor. Now here we'll discuss that what is nuclear reactor and how it works and what are its important components. Okay, so it is in this way that if we draw a rough diagram or you can say a block diagram. See, suppose this is a concrete chamber in which all this reaction is taking place. This is made up of concrete, so that the radiations which are coming out should not leave the reactor. Okay, and the energy which is coming out should be trapped in this reactor. So this is a concrete kind of a structure made. Here, the very first thing what we'll have is uranium rods. These are fuel rods. Okay, these are known as fuel rods. Now, the neutrons which are coming out from this, you can say, fission reaction are fast moving neutrons. So we need to slow them up. For slowing down those neutrons, here we'll have moderators. These blue color rods, they are moderators, and the function of these moderators are to slow down the fast moving neutrons. How they'll slow down? The neutrons will collide with the atoms of these moderators and elastically they'll collide and they'll lose their energy. So they'll be slowed down. Now those slow moving neutrons will be reacting with this uranium rod or fuel rods. Okay. Now, to control these amount of neutrons which are coming out, there are control rods, and they are movable control rods. They can be inserted deep inside this reactor and can be moved out. So these are control rods. Control rods are made up of cadmium or boron. Okay, now the amount of heat which is being produced here needs to be controlled or needs to be transferred in a way. So for that, the amount of heat which is being produced here will be transferred to a different chamber, you can say. Again, a concrete wall will be drawn here in this way. In order to differentiate them up, this concrete wall and these fuel rods, let us change the color for these. These green color, let us take them as fuel rods. And this black color as the concrete wall. So what will happen? Here, the energy which is there will be passed over here. and here it will, this energy will be rotated in a tube like structure, you can say. Here a pump is set up. This pump will push back this cool energy, you can say, or let us first, it's in this way. Here this energy is passed and here this water will be filled up. So, and here one outlet will be made for this water and here one inlet. So now what this outlet and inlet will do, and this entire thing will be filled with coolant. Okay, this coolant will regulate or it will absorb the amount of heat energy produced here. So this coolant is also filled in this pipe. So through this coolant, the energy also transferred in this pipe. And this pipe or the water around this pipe gets heated up and the steam is taken out from this outlet. Okay, and cold water is inlet from here. So in this way this nuclear reactor works, that we utilize this amount of heat produced here to generate a pressurized or high pressure steam. This high pressure steam is made to fall on the turbine of a generator, and from there the electricity or different kinds of work can be done. Basically electricity is produced from here. So high pressure steam is produced here, which is made to fall on the turbine, so that the turbine can rotate and the generator can work and it can produce electricity. Now let us see what is this fuel rods, control rods and moderators and coolant. So fuel rods are uranium or fissionable material. Mostly it is uranium-235. This is fuel rods. Then after these fuel rods, moderators are there. What these moderators will do, they'll slow down the neutrons. By elastic collisions or collision of neutrons and its atoms. Example for these moderators are heavy water, graphite and beryllium oxide. There are so many, so we'll just mention two examples. Then comes control rods. What these control rods will do, these control rods, they will control the rate of reaction by absorbing slow neutrons. These are made up of cadmium or boron. Okay, the function of the coolant will be to remove excess of heat produced in the reaction. For this also example is heavy water. heavy water is basically, instead of the formula for water is H2O, instead of this hydrogen, deuterium, an isotope of hydrogen will be used, deuterium. So D2O will be heavy water, because that deuterium is heavier than water, so it is, that's why it is called as heavy water. So one example is heavy water, or CO2 is also a best thing to absorb the amount of heat over here. Okay, so in this way the nuclear reactor works. So for your board examination of class 12th of ISC, the working of this nuclear reactor is to be understood, and these terms are very important. These are asked, that what these terms means and what are their examples, how do they work, in this way it is asked. Okay, I hope this is clear. Thank you.